Sometimes you may want to place some text at a specific location on the page, and putting the text into a text box gives you the freedom to easily move it wherever you want. To create a text box, go to the Insert tab and then Text Box. There are a number of built-in text boxes that have preset formatting, but you can also create a plain text box and format it yourself. Click Draw Text Box, and then in the document, click and drag to create it. And now you can type whatever you want, and you can format it just like you would with any other text. I'm going to change the font and the font size. I want the text to be in the middle of the text box, so I'll align it to center. I need it to be centered vertically as well, and before I do that, I'm going to remove the paragraph spacing because that can actually throw off the alignment. Now go to the Format tab and Align Text, and then you can choose the alignment type that you want. Because this is in a text box, we can move it around by just clicking the edge and dragging it wherever we want. Text boxes are really just a type of shape, so you can add shape styles to them. And if you go to the left of the shape styles, there is the Edit Shape command, and you can use this to change the shape. You may need to resize it again after you change the shape. Another great thing about text boxes is that they allow you to add effects to the text inside them, and this is called WordArt. I'd like to add an effect to Trivia Night. Even though this isn't in a text box right now, we can convert it into WordArt, which will put it into its own text box. Just go to the Insert tab and click WordArt, and then select a quick style. And this caused a lot of other things to shift, and that's because these objects are trying to wrap around the word art. So we just need to change the text wrapping setting to in front of text. Now that this is formatted as word art, it's inside its own text box, so it's that much easier to move everything around now. I'm just putting these roughly where I want them, and I'll fine-tune them later. Let's customize this word art a little more. Select the text box, and then in the Format tab, you can change the colors and effects. And these commands are found in the WordArt Styles group. I think I'll try a yellow fill and a purple outline. And then I'll change the outline weight. Finally, I'll choose a text effect. These are pretty much the same types of effects that you can add to shapes, but there's an extra one called Transform, and this will actually change the shape of the text. I think I'll choose this one. And once you've added a transform effect, the text will automatically stretch to fit the text box, even if you resize it. Now, you probably don't want to use WordArt in a more serious document such as a resume, but if you're just creating a fun, casual document like this flyer, it can really add a lot of energy.
Like what you just saw? Rate it.
Add a comment.
Subscribe to our channel.
The freedom to learn.
What you want, when you want.
Absolutely free.
GCFLearnFree.org.